Hello, everybody. Welcome to the introduction of ArrayCalc version 12. My name is Florian Hahn. I'm D&B's product manager for application software. And with me is my dear colleague Marco from R&D. He's the product owner of ArrayCalc. And we will give you a brief introduction into an evolutionary workflow optimization. Let's dive right into it. It's not about an electroacoustical improvement we want to talk about today. And 2 weeks ago, I showed this picture to some internal colleagues and asked for their response. And one of the responses was, this looks like chaos, but in fact, it is not. It's a grown infrastructure. It's pretty well organized and also documented. And this is how we try to look at how to improve our software offerings in ArrayCalc this time. So we looked at signal distribution, we looked at devices, our racks, down to Milan, of course, and documentation, because this so-called chaos, what it is not, of course, is well documented in several kind of ways. And now let's transfer this into ArrayCalc, into what we actually know, and you know that way better than we in D&B, because you experience that more or less on a daily basis. This is an infrastructural plan from our colleague Serge for Kraftwerk. And this signal distribution and device plan is a very good representation of what we collected. We identified systems become more and more complex, networks become more and more complex with more and more devices, device types, variants of devices. So what we came up with is what we call the patch plan. It's a visual system representation to support intuitive operation. I think now it's time for a demo with Marco to show you the real thing. Are you ready for this?
I'm always ready, Florian. Thank you.
So please take over.
Yeah, so welcome also from my side to this quick presentation. So when talking about software, it's always cool to have a hands-on because it's always something in motion, and just pictures are not showing really what's happening. The complete workflow, of course, at the beginning is as usual. You plan your venue, you plan your sources, you go ahead through the complete workflow, and when you reach devices, now there is something different. So if you design your sources from the scratch, there will not be any amplifiers automatically created in the background as it was before in ArrayCalc. This has a lot of advantages, which we see right now. So how to get to these amplifiers? Of course, you can still use the configure amplifiers button, which is now has become a bit more sophisticated in such a wizard, but I won't do this now. Let's have a look at the more visual things, because that's what Florian talked about. When it comes to complex things, let's have a look at that. So there's the patch plan view. If you look at that now, you just see some sources. Let's have a quick look and zoom a bit in how that looked like. So this is an array, it's the outfill left. You see this is an array by the icon. You can also see there are 8 cabinets. They are linked, which you can see with those lines. You see also there's a small hint, which tells you, hey, there is no amplifier channel yet connected. So let's do that. And what would you do intuitively? Yeah, maybe you would just right-click the source and have a look at what's offered here. And what we have is, for instance, adding just amplifiers. Let's try that. Okay, so what do we have here? This is a DAT amplifier. Let's get a bit closer. So you can see the input section on the left side, the output section on the right side. You can collapse and expand. And of course, you can interactively change your input routing and fit it to your needs. And as you can see, there are always live error indications if you missed something, in this case, an input source. And what you also can see is that if you hover items, you will see always the complete signal path, which helps you finding out what is already patched, where the signal goes, and where it comes from. Okay, let's have a look at another possibility to add amplifiers. Let's take this main hang here. And let's connect that to a system rack. Let's use a 3-unit standard rack in this case. And what happens is, for left and right side, there will be added a system rack with 3 amplifiers and a DS10 device inside. Let's have a closer look at that. So what you can see is that the rack is already patched internally. You have the input linking functionality, which is also new in ArrayCalc. And of course, also here you can always remove devices, select and hit delete, or right click and delete. You can also collapse and expand items inside the rack to have a better overview. And you can rename and edit things directly in the patch plan. So just double click and enter another name, for instance, or change the model of any device. Or what you also can do, of course, is changing remote IDs. So simply type in what you need. And if you want to do this in a more convenient way, you can use the start ID. So any rack offers the start ID, where you can simply type in the ID of the first amplifier, and ArrayCalc will automatically increment the ID through all the other amplifiers. So let's type in 201, for instance, and the first time gets 201, the second one gets 202, 203, and so on. So let's see also how a DS100 would look like in the patch plan. You can always add any devices up here in the plus menu. For instance, a DS100. So of course, this is a really big device because we have a lot of inputs and outputs. As I said, you can always collapse and expand sections, items to get more space. But let's have a look how to patch that to our DS10. So what you can do is, for instance, just select a section or any other multi-selection of channels and simply drag and drop the signal to your destination. And this is what will happen. Of course, you will be able to change the patch whenever you want to. Just grab the line, move it somewhere else. If you do some duplicate patch errors or something, you will always get an error indication. So let's quickly do a duplicate patch here. And you will see, okay, this generates an error, which you, by the way, will also see in the project report up here. Okay, now let's have a quick look at Milan. So as I said, you can always add any devices up here. So let's add a D90 amplifier. Let's have a look at that. So it's similar to a D80, but the difference is we have the Milan part in the on the input side. Okay. Now I will turn off the physical automatic layout and switch to a custom layout so that we can move items around and they keep their position. And this way I can put a DS100M just for demonstration really close to this one. Let's have a look at that. So DS100M looks like this. It has 8 streams. And each stream has 8 channels, but of course you just connect streams like this. And then, of course, you can change your input routing as you need it. Okay, so far, Florian.
I have 2 questions.
Yes, go ahead.
First question, can you add generic input devices?
Of course you can. Good question. So this is a feature which is in ArrayCalc. It has been there since already a few versions, but now in the patch plan, of course, you will also see it and it makes even more sense. And we extended this also to Milan devices. So let's type in a name, just select some inputs and outputs. I'm just doing this randomly now. And here you go with your custom generic device, which of course you can patch and integrate in your workflow. And if it's a Dante device, also the Dante export will work with this device. Another question, Florian.
Thank you. Could you do me a favor, add another DS10 device and duplicate the D90 amplifier maybe just a few times and then create a custom rack with it?
Ah, of course, yeah. This was a long one.
Yeah.
No problem. So let's first maybe disconnect the D90 from the D100M. Now we can add, you said a DS10, no problem. Let's add a DS10. Move it somewhere. We have a D90 already here. So let's just take that and duplicate it. This can be done by just right-clicking duplicate. Or what you also can do is use keyboard commands. And these are very powerful in the patch plan. So it's worth a look. And here we have a small helper for you, which is the list of keyboard commands. You can put that wherever you want and have a look at that. So let's have a look. The duplicate function is Control D. So let's use that one. So I just select also multiple devices, hit Control D, and I get these devices duplicate. And then of course you can move them around, but Florian asked me to create a custom rack with that. So let's select all of the devices I would like to have in the rack. And now you can have a look at the keyboard command, or you just have a look at the toolbar on the right-hand side. There is this group to rack function, Control G, and here you go. Your rack is ready. Now we played around a little bit with the tool. Let's have a look at a bigger project. How would that look like? So let's open just a soundscape example project we have. And by the way, we will update the example projects also with patch plan items. So if you open your already planned project, you will automatically get, of course, patch plan items. And they will be also positioned like here, meaning in a relation to the real world. So let's have a look at that. If we open the 3D plot, now this is kind of a FOH view, and you see that the positioning of the sources in the real world is really similar to what you see on the patch plan. Of course, this leads to a very zoomed out visualization. So that's why we also put in a slider where you can put things a bit more compact. So the sources will lose a bit of their real physical relation, but will be closer. Yeah. So, and if you have a look at this now in the overview state, you can quickly check if your DS100 here on the left side feeds all the sources. So let's quickly do that. So I just hover, I just go down with the mouse, and you can see the complete signal flow and check if any source is missing an input signal. Of course, this can be done also the other way around, or in between, wherever you find any line you want to check, where does that go? Okay. To hide the patch lines, if in such a case you see a lot of crisscrossing lines here, if you want to get a cleaner picture, you can just hide the lines and still you would get the signal path as soon as you hover, which makes it a bit more clear. Maybe also a quick word to the colors now that we are zoomed in here. So you see a color legend on top. Dante signals are colored in yellow and Milan in pink and so on and so forth. This is also related to our workflow, which is suggested by DNB in general for color codes. Florian.
Could you do me a favor? Delete maybe the first 16 patches, select both devices and hit C.
You know already the keyboard commands.
Yeah. I read them this morning.
Yeah, okay. So let me also use some commands. So I will hit the D command, which is a disconnect. There's also always a button for these functions, but it makes things really quick if you use keyboard commands. So I will hit D and it disconnects everything here. I can keep selected the DS100 outputs. In addition, by holding down Control, I can select another group, which is the DS10 input section, and now I hit C and everything is connected. Of course, this also works with a bigger selection. As far as there is a unique way how to connect things, ArrayCalc will do this automatically for you. If there are multiple DS10 devices in a selection, of course, ArrayCalc cannot know which one you want to use for which source. Usually, ArrayCalc can try to find the best way to patch your selection. If you look at this plan, if you want to just have an export of this, there is a what you see is what you get export, which is the overview. Let's use the preview to directly show you what happens. So let's have a look at this. So this is the overview export. And of course, if you would print this, it would look like it would be too small, of course. But for digital use, this can be really useful because you can zoom in and you will see all the labels, all the signals, your user-defined names of the DS100, where the signal goes to, where it comes from, and you can follow the complete chain. Now let's have a look at other options. So there is the all devices export, which then is more a real printable version. So what you can see here is all the amplifiers. I'll zoom in a bit, with the signal where it comes from and where it goes to, with rec information in the header, and also with information about linked cabinets. So this can really be used directly to mount your system on site. If you scroll down, you see all the amplifiers, and at the end there will be the DS10 devices as well, like this. And also here you see where the signal comes from, the DS100, and where it goes to on the amplifier side. And at the end of the document, you will find the DS100 as well, separated in different sections. So this is the printable version. If you, for instance, would like just to hand out one side of the PA, you quickly can select sources you want to mount and then select the selected items export. And what you get now here is a way shorter list, which is just reflecting what you selected in the patch plan. So these are only amplifiers used by the sources you selected. This makes things then a bit easier when you hand out the sheets. Okay. Florian, do you have any further questions?
What about displaying the patch plan on a second screen?
Ah, that's a good one. Yeah. So as this is a really a tool where you really need a lot of space, it makes sense if you're working in an office and have an extra screen to use this function so that you can have it full screen, maybe on your second monitor. And what's also easy, in parallel, work in ArrayCalc. So this is not locking your ArrayCalc application, but you can continue working here and maybe have a look at the 3D plot or whatever you want on your main screen. The selection of the sources in the complete application is reflected in the patch plan, so you can quickly see where the sources are positioned and how they are patched.
Thank you, Marco.
You're welcome.
So thank you for your attention. I hope you are going to have a nice day. Take care until then.
See you.
See you.